Hi everyone. Today in this video, let us discuss Tacrolimus. What is this drug Tacrolimus? Here we can identify one of the suffix imus. So drugs ending with suffix imus are commonly known as immunosuppressants. So Tacrolimus is an immunosuppressant. This drug targets the T cell activity. So T cell proliferation is going to be inhibited by this drug, which results in the immunosuppression. That's why Tacrolimus can be used by topical purpose as an immunosuppressant for the treatment of atopic dermatitis. This is a skin disorder with enhanced immune activity. Such immune-based skin reactions can be controlled by Tacrolimus. This drug can also be used by systemic route as an immunosuppressant during organ transplantation. But today in this video, we are going to see how this drug is useful by topical route as ointment. And this drug can be used even in the children with age greater than 2 years. So Tacrolimus ointment is available both for pediatric purpose as well as adults. But in the children with age less than 2 years, this drug should not be used. So first of all, let us see how this Tacrolimus acts. On the T cell receptors are present, which are activated when antigen component interacts with these receptors. So antigens can stimulate the T cell activity. When they bind to T cell receptor, they can activate the ion channel, calcium channel. Now calcium can enter into the T cells, which activates the T cell proliferation. One of the targets for this calcium is the calcineurin. Now calcium can bind to this calcineurin, forming a calcium-calcineurin complex, which is then activated, and then it targets NFAT, nuclear factor of activated T cells. Now the activated NFAT can then target the DNA within the nucleus. So it can interact with the DNA such that it can produce a gene transcription and protein synthesis. And one of the protein that is going to be formed is the IL-2, which is released from the T cells. Now this IL-2 can act on the IL-2 receptors, which increase the T cell amplification. So immune response is further increased by release of IL-2. Now Tacrolimus is one of the immunosuppressant which can inhibit the T cell immune activity. One of the target for the Tacrolimus is the FKBP. This is one of the binding protein commonly known as FK506 binding protein. Now Tacrolimus can bind to this FKBP such that it can form a complex with calcineurin, which inhibits the activity of calcineurin. This results in the reduced activation of NFAT. So NFAT undergoes dephosphorylation, resulting in the inactivation. Finally, this results in the decreased gene transcription and reduced release of IL-2. In this way, Tacrolimus can suppress the immune response by reducing the gene transcription and IL-2 production. Now let us see the precautions of this drug. One of the important precautions of Tacrolimus is that this drug can reduce the immunity, so it can reduce the T cell activity. Because of reduced immune response, it can increase the risk of infections, particularly viral infections are increased. So risk of varicella zoster infections, herpes simplex viral infections can be increased when this cream is applied topically. That's why Tacrolimus cream should be used after removing any topical infection, because this can reduce the immunity and can further increase the viral infections. Similarly, this drug can produce some skin burning, as well as it can produce pruritus, resulting in the itching. These two effects are observed with this Tacrolimus cream, and these can be observed even after few hours after application of this cream. At an average, skin burning sensation can be observed within 15 minutes of the application, and pruritus can be observed within 20 minutes, but they can be extended up to few hours. So caution should be taken when these are more pronounced in the patients. And in case of severe allergic reactions, this drug should be withdrawn. Similarly, this drug can increase the risk of phototoxicity. Even it is not completely phototoxic, but it can increase the risk of UV radiation carcinogenicity. So it can increase the risk of cancer formation on exposure to the high radiation of UV light. And it can also increase the skin tumors when the person is exposed to harmful radiation. That's why Tacrolimus should be carefully used, and direct exposure to the sunlight or harmful radiation should be avoided in order to reduce the phototoxicity. and this drug should not be given to the children with scaly skin disorders. For instance, Netherton's syndrome is one of the conditions with red and scaly skin on which, if tacrolimus is applied, it can more absorb into the systemic circulation, resulting in toxic effects. So in such conditions, tacrolimus should not be used. Again, caution should be taken because tacrolimus can increase the swelling of lymph nodes. Even this effect is more pronounced by systemic route, but still care should be taken when this drug is applied by topical route because of any minor absorption through the skin. Similarly, whenever tacrolimus is applied, the occlusal dressing should not be placed because they can increase the systemic absorption. With increased systemic absorption, tacrolimus produces immunosuppression, resulting in viral infections, swelling of lymphs. That's why when this cream is applied, occlusal dressing should not be placed in order to reduce the systemic absorption. Now let us see the side effects of this drug. Most of the side effects are local reactions, and few of the side effects can be observed due to systemic absorption. Tacrolimus can produce skin burning, erythema, redness of the skin, pruritus, itching sensation. Some allergic reactions can be produced by this drug. And it can also produce some dry skin, which further increases the skin burning and tingling sensation. It can also produce rhinitis, headache, skin infections. Because this drug is an immunosuppressant, it can increase the further skin infections. And diarrhea, flu-like symptoms can be observed with this tacrolimus. How it is given? This drug is available as an ointment for topical purpose. For systemic purpose, it is available as a capsule. But topically, it is applied as an ointment at two strengths, 0.03% and 0.1%. The low concentration, that is 0.03%, is indicated for the treatment in the pediatric patients. So in the children with age 2 to 15 years, this drug can be given for topical treatment of atopic dermatitis. Similarly, in the adults, we can use the 0.1%. So that's about this drug, tacrolimus, which is an immunosuppressant. This drug reduces the T-cell activity and T-cell proliferation by inhibiting the gene transcription and proliferation of IL-2 and other immune mediators. Due to the decreased immune response, it can reduce inflammatory reactions associated with immune activity. And this drug can be used both in the pediatrics as well as in the adults. In the children with age less than 2 years, this drug is not indicated. Because of immune suppression, this drug can increase the risk of skin infections, and it can also produce some skin burning, skin dryness, itching. And this drug, when applied on the skin, the patient should not be directly exposed to the sunlight to reduce the development of any phototoxicity. So that's all about this drug, tacrolimus, used for topical purpose. So that's for today. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel, share this video with your friends, post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.